So when we are talking about the orbit, this is a fixed circular path taken by electron. So when the electron is moving, that path they are taking is called the orbit. Like now, if this is a bus stop A, this is another bus stop B, and this is the main road. A vehicle can move from this place. If you enter a vehicle in this bus stop, it can carry you from here now to this point. This direction it is following is a path. It is the main road. Main road. It cannot fly in the air. It must pass through the main road. That main road now is the orbit. So whenever electron is moving, that path they follow, that road they follow to travel, that is called the orbit. It is the path taken by the electron. Because when electron is going to their house, a kind of house of electron is the orbiter. They must follow a path. They must follow a direction. That particular direction they are following is called the orbit. So for a driver or for a bus to move from a bus stop A to bus stop B, it must follow the main road. It cannot fly in the air. So that particular road it is following to go to the destination, that is called the orbit. Now, when we have an atom, this is the structure of an atom, for instance. This is the nucleus of the atom. The nucleus of the atom is positively charged because of the presence of the proton there. Now, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, and the electron is negatively charged. These electrons are revolving around the nucleus. This circular path that the electron is following, this circular path that the electron is following, is what is called the orbit. The orbit. The orbit. This is the circular path that the electron is following. Electron cannot follow here. Electron cannot follow here. This is a kind of the main road for them. The road that is designed for them to follow. They can't follow this place because this place is not designed for them to move. Just like a vehicle cannot follow this place because there is no main road there. This is the major road that the vehicle can follow. Maybe these places are filled with grasses. These places are filled with grasses. The vehicle cannot travel there. But this particular path it can follow to reach the destination is the orbit. The same thing is applicable to the atoms. In the atom, we have what is called the orbit, and the orbit is where the electrons are following, the path taken by the electrons. So that's the meaning of orbit. Then the next is orbital. Orbital is just is similar to the orbit. Like this is orbit, then if you remove AL, you have the orbit. The other one is the orbital, but they are different. That their spelling is similar does not mean that they are the same thing. This is O, orbit, orbital. The meaning of orbital. Orbital. Now, let's use the same analogy here because we said that this is a bus stop A, this is a bus stop B. Maybe you tell a bus to stop in this bus stop A, then you enter the vehicle. When you enter the vehicle now, this is you inside, then the vehicle will carry you. Once you reach this bus stop, you say, driver, I want to stop here. Then the driver will stop you. There is a road that the driver followed. That particular road that the driver follow before he drop you is the orbit. But you, if I'm looking for you now, where I will see you is in this bus stop. I can no longer see you in this bus stop because you have traveled from this bus stop to this bus stop. Now, anytime I'm looking for you, I will locate you in bus stop B because that is your final destination. That place becomes the orbital. Orbital. So when we are talking about the orbital, it is a space or region in an atom where we have the maximum probability of finding electron. So if I'm looking for this man now, this is the guy, this is him. Yeah, he entered a bus in bus stop A and the vehicle carried him along this road and stopped him at bus stop B. So if I'm looking for him, I can no longer see him in bus stop A, but I will see him in bus stop B. Maybe drinking water or doing something else. So in that case now, this guy in bus stop B, this is his actual location at this point. But he didn't just jump and come to this place. He followed the road. He followed the platform. He followed the direction, the main road. That is the orbit. But the orbital is this location he is now. If I'm looking for him, I will find him in bus stop B, which is the orbital. So the major difference between orbit and orbital is that orbit is the path, the direction, the pathway that the electron follows when they are going. But where are they going to? The destination of the electron is to go to the orbital. So whenever you are looking for the electron, they want to go to somewhere. That place they will reach and they will start rejoicing at that point is their orbital. Anybody you see on the main road is running to go to somewhere, either to their house or to lesson center or to school. And you can't just jump and reach that place. You must follow a road. That road you are following is the orbit. But where are you going to? Your destination, where you will end, that is the orbital. So that is the major difference between the orbit and the orbital. Orbit is just the region, the circular path taken by the electron. But the orbital is a space in an atom where there is a maximum probability of finding an electron. We said that orbital this is a region or space in an atom where there is a maximum probability of finding an electron. So that is the definition of orbital. Then types of orbitals or examples of orbitals. Examples of orbitals. We have number one, the S orbital. The S orbital, the shape of S orbital is spherical. It is spherical in shape. Spherical in shape. So the diagram of the S orbital is something like this. This is the Y axis, this is the X axis. So this is the shape of the S orbital. S orbital is spherical in shape. Then another orbital we have is the P. The P orbitals. The P orbitals, they have a dumbbell shape. And when we are talking about the P orbitals, the possible P orbitals are the PX orbital, the PY orbital, and the PZ orbital. These are the P orbitals. The PX orbital, PY orbital, and PZ orbital, they are three in number. And their shape is a dumbbell. The drawing is something like this. This is a PX orbital. This is the Y axis, X, PY orbital. This is the Z axis, this is the Y axis, this is the X axis, this is the Z orbital. So these are the various orbitals of P. Then next is D. So I've given number one, number two. Number three is D orbitals. D orbital, the shape is a double dumbbell. Double dumbbell. Dumbbell shape. So they have double dumbbell shape. Examples of the D orbitals are the DXY, DXZ, DYZ, DX square minus Y square, and this their square. They are five in number. The d orbital is five in number. There are five in number. The s orbital is just one. Then the p orbital is three. You have three p orbitals. There are three in number. So the diagram for the dx, dxy, dxz, and the remaining one is this. So if this is the y axis and we are using it as our x axis, the lobes are pointing in between the axes. So for the fact that this place is x, this place is y, we call this dxy orbital. So that is the structure for the dxy orbital. Then the next one, dxz, if I have this, then here is my z, and this place is x. For the fact that I label here x and z, I can call this dxz orbital. Then I can also have the next one. This one is y and z. This place I can call it y. This place is z. So the orientation is between y and z. So I can call it dyz orbital. There are three in number. These three orbitals put together are called the T2G orbitals. T2G orbitals. T2G orbitals. Then the remaining two, making it five, because we said that five in number, we have drawn three. One, two, three. If you look at them, they have similar shape. It's just that the orientation differs. This is between X and Y, between X and Z, between Y and Z, but the shape is the same thing, and the shape is a double dumbbell. This is one dumbbell. This is another dumbbell, making it a double. Like this is just a dumbbell. This is a dumbbell. This is a dumbbell. But this one is double of that dumbbell. So this is the three of them put together. You can call them the T2G orbitals. Then the remaining two is this. The X square minus Y square. That is this. If you look at these orbitals, the lobes are pointing along the axis. This is pointing along the axis, But this is pointing in between. In between the axis, that is where you see the lobe. In between the axis. But this one is pointing along the axis. So this one is also pointing along the axis. That is different between the T2G and the epsilon G. The T2G, they are pointing in between the axis, but this one is on the axis, along the axis. So this is the dxy minus y square. Then this is the dz square. Two of them put together are called the epsilon g orbital. So these are the five orbitals of d, and they are said to be degenerate orbital. Degenerate orbital, the spelling is this, degenerate orbitals. It simply means orbitals with the same energy level. So when orbitals have the same energy level, you call them degenerate orbital. Like if you have a 3px, 3py, and 3pz. All these are p orbitals, but their energy is the same. 3, 3, 3. They are degenerate orbitals. If I have something like 4dxy, 4dxz, 4dy square z, 4dx square minus y square, and 4. The number here, the energy level is the same. 4, 4, 4. They are said to be degenerate orbitals. So when you use the word degenerate orbital, it simply means orbital with the same energy level. In other words, they belong to the same principal quantum number, or they belong to the same shell because they have the same NO value. So that is the difference between orbit and orbitals, shells, and the subshell. Next is the F orbital, because we have the S, P, D, and F. The shape of this one is complex. It has a complex shape. And because of the complex nature of it, the drawing of the figure is unlike that of S, P, and D. So, and the number of orbitals of this is seven orbitals. In other words, the maximum number of electrons that F can carry is 14, because 2 times 7 will give you 14. The meaning of each of these, like the full meaning of S is sharp. The full meaning of P is principal. The full meaning of D is diffuse. And the full meaning of F is fundamental. That is the meaning of all these letters that are used here. S, P, D, and F. They stand for sharp, principal, diffuse, and fundamental. So that is it for the orbitals.